خيانتك.
Where's
he going? He about to ride.
My brother's y'all.
Thank you.
much with the rhythm.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming. But I was in the garage at home. Piece of metal fell out the top of the ceiling. Caught me right in the top of the head. So I had to go get that. Taken care of. When I have the hat on, it feels better when I take it off. And get the air just makes it feel bad. So that's why you see me with the hat. Amen? So God, just forgive me for that incident. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. You owe salvation, purchased of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story. This is my song.
Praise Him.
Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior, praising my Savior, praising my Savior all day long. Let's bow our heads. Most gracious and loving God, we thank you for another day that you allowed us just to see, just allowed us to be a part of. And Lord, we know it's nothing that we've done to be here. It's all because of your grace and mercy. But Father, we come now to celebrate a life well lived. We come now, Lord, to celebrate a life that you give to this family.
Yeah.
For the time that you designated to be so.
Yeah.
And Father, we just say thank you.
Thank you.
Father, we just ask now that you just lock all of the memories and times, good times, blessed times, and pleasurable times.
Yeah.
Lock them up in our memories, Lord God. Lock them up in the family memories so they'll have something to look back and pull down and cherish on, Lord God, knowing that you blessed the family and friends and loved ones with this life.
Yeah.
Father, we say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We say thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
But Lord, even more so, we want to ask you just to strengthen our hearts and get into our lives and our hearts and our thoughts and our minds so that we can meet again.
Yeah.
In that great getting up morning where we can realize and say howdy, howdy, no more goodbyes. Praise Him for the life that has brought us through to see them again. So, Father, we just give you glory. We give you honor And we give you all the praise. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Ah, amen, amen, amen.
Father, good brother. You'll never know when it's the last time you talk to me. I was able to tell her I love her.
I can't do it every day. Everybody. I am Petra. I am one of Trey's sisters. I don't want to come up with a crap because think about the good times. So Trey is hilarious. For those who know him, you know, sometimes I can't even take him serious because Trey is just Trey. Trey loves my kids, you know, like they his kids. You know, he always messed with my son Jake because I had Jay at a young age. So, you know, Jake is a little up there in age. And Jay used to go to the jobs with Trevin and my dad. And one day he was like, man, I seen my nephew, man. He's about bigger than me. I said, he's bigger than me, Trevin. He is about bigger than you. He loves everybody. You know, you very rarely see him upset. If he's upset, it's something that really made him mad. You know, he's a loving person. You know, I'm going to miss him calling me. And, he'll call me, like, so it's a real nickel. It's a real nickel calling to tell you that he loves you. I was like, I love you too, Trevin. You know, and he's just, you know, he was just that person that just randomly do stuff like that. Or he'd tell me to come and have some, what he called a barbecue? Some big booty barbecue. Say some cooking, some big booty barbecue. You know, you kids, come on, do it.
Put it in there because I used to work two jobs and come home late, and Hello everyone, to those of you who I haven't seen. We always think we have our time, don't we? We always think that we have our time. doing what we all know he does, and that is extending himself to help in the way that he can. He's helping you to move back to Atlanta, and he and I, and Keith, and Jared, all of them are my baby brothers as far as Kevin's first baby. I remember being there. I remember when he came home from Camp Washington High School. I remember when he was born and how he just fought the odds. He defeated all the odds. 3 pounds and 3 ounces. And he just grew into this man who was complex like most of us. He had his shadows, and he had his light, and his light outshined all of that, and everyone in this room can attest to. He loved hard, he fought hard, he worked hard, and then he loved hard again. And one of the many memorable memories I have with him, I think I was here visiting. I was home with Howard at the time. And I needed a ride somewhere. And I was in the house waiting for Trevor to come. And I had been calling him because I had been waiting, as he loved to do. Because he did everything. He's like Frank Sinatra, who did it his way. And I just remember waiting, like, dang, is he ever going to come? And all of a sudden, I hear this boom, 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 boom. I hear this bass. And he drove up, and he was playing this song by Outkast that I had never heard before called Liberation. And that's the first thing I thought of after my initial shock, which I'm still working through, that he is free. He has worked out his liberation. And he is free. And he took care of everyone's heart in these last few weeks. He wanted everyone to know how much he loved and appreciated them. And I will echo other family members who say that we have to take care of each other and love on each other. And I will add to this that we also have to take care of our own heart and take care of ourselves. We have to eat right. We have to exercise. We have to drink water. We have to eat some greens, even though we may not like it sometimes. But we have to take care of ourselves. Who knows? Maybe we'll take care of ourselves, and the Most High will still call us home in an untimely accident or whatever. But while we're here, these bodies are a temple, and we all fall short of the glory when it comes to taking care of our temple, but in some it's worth the effort. So I'll just leave you with that. Take care of each other's heart. Take care of your own heart.
Amen. Amen.
Closeness with each other. And he was a very hard worker. And that day when he came over there and offered him some spaghetti, he said, I love to eat. I eat a lot of food. So I gave him a plate of spaghetti with garlic bread and some cranberry juice. And he ate it. And then he found out, he said, are you Carnell Drayton's mom? I said, yeah, that's my son. It's my oldest son. You know, and I'm so happy that I got a chance to meet him and talk to him. But, you know, I was, when I found out that happened to him, that really broke my heart, you know? Because I was looking for him to come back, you know, to the house. And, you know, he's just a hard worker with pastor. And he loved what he did. So I had to come up here and say something, you know? Well, you know, to God be the glory. We just don't know when it's our time, you know? Now is the time to do what you got to do. You can't wait today. You have to get ready. You have to be ready today. You can't say, oh, well, I'll do it tomorrow. No, you have to do it today. Get it together today. Because I just buried, like, a couple of weeks ago, I had two relative young men that had a massive heart attack. Both of them passed away. So then when I heard about him, I was like, wow, Jesus is coming soon. Let me think, he's coming back. So we got to make sure we're ready today.
Yes, yes.
Today you have to be ready. But, you know, and Travis, he did knew the Lord because me and him talked.
Yes.
He knew the Lord. Me and him talked one day, you know, he was telling me some stuff, you know, and I believe that he knew the Lord by listening to him and him telling me, you know, some things that he shared with me. So, you know, I just bless God to get a chance to meet him, you know. He's an amazing young man. And I know his mom, I didn't know that was his mom, but sorry about that, but he knew the Lord, so that will help you along the way, knowing that he knew who Christ was. Thank you for listening to me.
Amen.
Amen.
Good evening, everybody. I am Trevin's auntie. And I'm sure every one of his aunties that he has probably feels like they are his only auntie. Because that's the way he made you feel. Trevin is the type of person that is always happy for everybody else. Always giving everybody else their props, always. He was just, or is, just a beautiful, beautiful man. And he and I have had some very, very long talks because you know how these days we call our kids, they're just, most of the time we feel that they're just not doing the right thing. And Trevin and I always had to have these conversations about him doing the right thing. Trevin, you need to take your medication. Trevin, you need to stop getting so angry. Trevin, you need to calm down. But I just feel like when we are here on this earth, we're here for a reason.
6:55 p.m.
When we get ready to go, we're not going anywhere till God is ready for us to go. When we go, it's our time to go. Trevin left, it was Trevin's time to go. But Trevin lived a life that I know everybody in here knew that Trevin made them all feel so special. He's so proud of his brother, so proud of his kids, loved his mom like nobody I've ever known. They had this special bond that it's just a beautiful, beautiful bond that they had together. And I would just like to say to all of us, to all of you, you know, we have to love each other. We have to love each other unconditionally. So many times we see our children and they are not doing what we think they should be doing. And we don't want to accept the things that they accept. But at the end of the day, God is all about love, and it's the love that we feel for each other. You know, I might not like your lifestyle, you might not like my lifestyle, but let's just try to love and accept each other unconditionally, because that's what it's all about. And I just know that Trevin knew that he was a love person. On March 22nd, just a couple of weeks ago, Trevin sent us out a message. He said, "Good morning, fam. I just wanted all of you all to know just how much I love y'all. Just how much I know y'all love me. Thank you so much for taking care of my kids, from TJ to Kayla, 9. That's what he sent us. This was March 22nd. And who would ever think that on April 10th, Trevin would be gone for months? But that's the way God planned it. You know, Trevin had this massive, massive heart attack. And God took him that way. And I said to myself, sometimes you question God. And I asked myself, why did he have to go drive in a car? And then I thought to myself, Trevin was at the house with the kids. God didn't want those kids to see him have a massive heart attack like that. So Trevin had the heart attack coming from the 7-Eleven, doing what he do. He came, went to the 7-Eleven, had his heart attack, went on the side of the road, and he left this earth. But he will leave us with a legacy that is unbelievable. Trevin was a beautiful guy, and I remember saying to him just about 2 months ago, I looked at him, I said, "Dad, you look pretty." His skin was just glowing. He just looked so good to me. And we talked about that. "Oh, auntie, you just talking. And I'm like, "No, you really, really." He had like a glow on his face that I can't even describe. And his mom can attest to this, because when she looked at me, she smiled when I said that to him, because he gave me that little smirk, like, wow. She's telling me that I look good, but everybody should try to take on an attitude that Trevin had. Trevin was a great guy, and I'm not standing here trying to make anybody think that Trevin was perfect, because Trevin was not perfect. Trevin had his flaws. Just like Trish has her flaws. This one has their flaws. We all got our flaws. But Trevin, to his core, was one of the best men we ever meet. So I say to everybody, if you could just love just half the way that Trevin loved, I think that you would be okay. Thank you, everybody. Now, somebody else has to come up here and say something about Trevin. We see all these people sitting here, and everybody here loved Trevin. So here comes his mom, and here comes his brother.
That was truly my boy. He was a preemie, and it took him a long time to get big, but when he got big, he was a big boy, but I think I kept him a baby a long time, maybe a little too long, because he was like a mama, he was a mama boy. And it was always, mommy, mommy, mommy. So it's like, I'm saying to myself, who is this boy gonna stop calling me mommy? But I was his mommy, he was my baby. And the way I raised him, he knew the Lord. And I raised him in the church to love and to love everybody. Not to judge people for who they were, or what they did, or whatever. Trevin didn't judge. He loved everybody. And he truly loved everybody. Sometimes I would get mad at him because people, you know, sometimes when you love, people take your love for reasons. And a lot of times people do things for people, and it's like they took advantage of them. I would say, but that's the way I raised him. I raised him to love and to do for people if he could. And he, that's the way he lived. And sometimes he was taking advantage of, but I would always tell him, that's their loss in your case. Because when you do wrong to people, you don't win. So I always tell him, in the end, always. So you keep on loving. Don't let anything people do to you stop you from loving others. I taught him that, and sometimes it can make me mad because, you know, sometimes he wasn't treated right, but he came on loving like I'm talking about. And I'm going to tell you something because everybody was his friend. You know, anybody he met, we went to Georgia one time to my aunt's home down. And it's got one ring at night. And if you go too fast, you're going to see half of them. A half a mile long. And we were in the store in the town. And there was a guy in there. Everybody loved to help people if he could, and truly this because there's some people that don't come here. Don't be looking at that. This person is here. It's truly just a type of person. Because he was my son. He loves. And it's true. He really loves. I thank everybody for coming out. And this is your chance to be better. Everybody in here, this is her.
Cooking every day. So they was really tight, and that's how I got to know Trayvon. And it just was something special about Trayvon. Like, we connected together, because it's like we was going through the same situation. So, like, he needed to talk, he'll call me. We'll talk about whatever. I put him back on track. And I was like, you know, Trey, you got new kids. Whatever you're going through or whatever's troubling you, don't let it. Don't let it. And I would tell him, you got to sometimes let things go. I had to learn it. I used to be just like him, let people walk all over me. My brother was going to fight the people. Because she'd be like, Mom, you just got a pure heart. You just too good. And I'd be like, well, you know, maybe God just held me on earth for that reason, you know? And so I would talk to Trayvon because, like I said, I just felt like God put him, like Winston put us together for a reason. So I used to always just talk to Trayvon and, like, put him back on track. Because it's like sometimes he'll be like, man, I really don't want to go back where I used to be. And I'd be like, yes, Lord, that's why you got me. So we don't have to go back. I say, I got your back. I'm going to always be on your side to the bitter end. And it just hurt me. I couldn't believe it when Winston called me, because I was waiting on this dude to come get a plate of food. Because he called me that Sunday. We talked through the day. And he knows I like volunteer my time to this elderly lady. I take care of her. She don't have a kid. So I take care of her on the weekend. So that's where I was. He's like, Sean, you didn't cook, right? Because you was down south. I was like, no, I didn't, but guess what? I'm on my way home now. I'm going to go put some food on the stove. He's like, what did you cook? I said, yellow rice, pork shoulder, and some lima beans. He's like, ooh, girl, fix me a plate. I said, I got you. I'm fixing it. Soon as I call you. So we was talking, and he was like, Sean, I'm going to call you back. TJ and something. So after that, you know, I'm waiting. I didn't call him back. I finished cooking. I didn't even get a text. So I was like, that's pretty strange. I said, so he must have been getting off at 10 o'clock. So I was like, well, maybe he just gonna pop up and come and get the plate, because I told him, when you get off, the plate gonna be ready. So then it was really weird. Winston called me. He never calls me. So he was like, Sus, what you doing? I said, cooking. Cooking what? So I told him immediately, oh, I'm coming over there. So I'm thinking him and Trey is together, but it's the other one that I didn't meet. So I'm waiting on the both of them. It's 11 o'clock. I'm like, I got to go to work. I'm not waiting on these fools. Like, I'm gonna put this food in the refrigerator, and then Winston, I'll take his plate to work. So that next day, Winston called me with the bad news, and I was like really sad. I couldn't even like talk to Winston. I'm like calling the phone, like, he said, what? Say that again. And he was like, rock on. I was like, no, he can't be wrong, because I talked to him most of the day Sunday. Like, what are you saying? For real. So I really miss Trayvon. Even though it was the middle of the time, I got to know him. He's a good person.
Amen. Amen.
Well, for those that don't know, I'm Richard, Big Rich. No reason I'm gonna be rich, same one from before. Trail. I met Trail when I was 8 years old. Mm-hmm. Westside Baptist Church, summer school, summer camp. And, you know, we went back to school. I was like, I go to Kobe, I go to Nova. So I'm like, okay, I'll see you next summer. And come to find out, like, maybe 2 weeks later, we at the same church, YPD, choir, running around here, sleepovers, going on the summer trips with Pastor Robin and everybody that was involved, Mom, everybody that took us to where we had to go. And I'm the only child. I have two older sisters. I have no brothers, but through Trevor, which I call T-Rock, the Rock.
That's right.
The Rock, that brought all this together. I met Winston, DJ, he was with Jerry and Keith, Tyrone, Galvin came on later on. But through Trevor, and by the grace of God, knowing him, I get a lot of brothers. Ramon, oh man, there's so many. There's so many people that I met. Chill Will, Al. just people. And I just thought about it the other day when I was like, I called Trevor T-Rock all the time. And not realize he was the rock for everybody.
Amen.
No matter what we went through, no matter what I went through, he was there. When my dad passed away, he was there. When his dad passed away, I was there. Just back and forth. Like the Bible says, you gotta show yourself friendly to have friends. But you're gonna have that one friend that stay closer than a brother. And that was my brother, man. We might not have been blood, but that's my brother. Spend the night at my house. Oh, Trevor spent the night at my house. I'm gonna spend the night at my house, but we in the streets. Places we were supposed to be. We met at a lot of places. Uncle Curtis taking us to places we ain't supposed to be. Just, man, that was my family. And I'm gonna miss, he's gonna be missed. He's gonna be sorely missed. And when I got the phone call, and I had to call Janelle and call Mom. I don't know. It's something I never want to go through again. Never want to go through. And I just say, I'm sorry, he's gone, but you still got sons, he's still here. His kids got uncles. They got a lot of uncles, they got a lot of aunties, so they not never want for nothing. And we still all family. And just, Trevor just knew, because I was talking to him, he was trying to get right. He was really trying to get right. We was talking about God a lot. He wanted to have Bible study. He was getting everything together with life insurance. Like, I never seen Trevor turn around like how he did. And he says, I know he in a better place. The flesh hurt, but the spirit going to be all right.
Right.
And we got to believe. Yeah. We got to trust and believe. I just want to give all the glory to God and just thank him for the time I did have to spend with him on earth. The last we had, the good times we had, we fought like brothers. And it just, I've been down with him for a week. I'm like, Trey, come on, man, stop tripping. But that's just who he was. Big heart, always good. If he had the time to do it, he was going to do it. And he was going to be missed. And I just want to thank everybody for coming out and giving my support and the family support. Yeah, I will.
I just want to say, Richard showed up, told a lot about my brother, said a lot about T-Rock, you know what I mean? Oh man, to God be the glory for a beautiful life. To God be the glory for everything that he does, he is right. We showed up, we think of the good times with T-Rock, with Trevor. Oh man, what a man he was. So many things that he can do. So many trades that man can do. That man, he know how to do it all. You say it, he know how, he got some type of knowledge in it.
Okay.
I tell you no lie, T-Rock, you showed up, taught me a lot. You showed up, was there when as we were kids. Me and Richard, Keith, Trevin, Jared, Tyrone, TT, all of YPD, right here at this church, sung in the choir, voice of the praise. And I'm saying to it down. Oh, God. And just give God the praise that we have had the opportunity to experience an angel in the flesh. To make us laugh, show us the way, show us not the way, show us the way, how to repent, keep going. You know what I mean? Take it as a hell. Like, Tiba, I need that, man. Chill out. But to God be the glory, we've seen this man grow in so many ways. I just want to say that what this man said is 100% true about T-Rock. I'm going to tell you right now, it would be a dishonor for if you know this man, to not say something about this man. Something he did to make you laugh, something he said to make you cry, to make you feel some type of way. Everything that he said and was 100%. Love it or hate it, it was what it was, it is what it is, and you know what I mean? With T-Rock, he gave it to you raw. You know what I'm saying? I give God the praise. I was just sad to hear what happened to my brother, or how it happened to my brother. But I know that the God that we serve make no mistakes. We. Oh man, it's just so many people that want to say something about this man. So I just want to say I give God the praise for me having this opportunity to take the honor to say something about this man. You know what I'm saying? Because this man hit and touched so many people's lives. If it wasn't for his life, a lot of us wouldn't even be here connected together, to be honest with you. He was that type of lighthouse in his own little way. You know what I mean? We all had his light. I just pray that we do right by, you know what I'm saying? Stop living worldly and just be ye holy. That's what God wants us to be. Be ye holy like he. Just be ye holy. This man was trying. I give that man 100% A+ for credit for moving forward. For all he did, he still climbed out that bucket. And it's sad to say that a lot of us, man, he showed us how to get out in so many ways to one. It's just a blessing and an honor to know my brother. You know what I'm saying? Just take care of yourself so we don't, you know what I'm saying, be caught up as well. Because it's sometimes it's 100% you. So you just got to make the right decisions like my brother trying to do. So I'm going to just pass this mic and say to God be the glory. God bless you, Trevor. I pray that you, I know you in heaven.
Good evening, everyone. The church say amen.
Amen.
The church say amen.
Amen.
Can we get a round of applause for God in here right now? Give God some praise. Give God some praise. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of the privileged memories that I have with my brother and my mother. That's gonna allow him to continue to live in my heart. So I'm not gonna say goodbye, I'm just gonna say I'll see you later. And that I love you. Mom, you know I love you. Family, you all know how I stand, where I stand. I love you all so much. My church family, Richard, Ramon, everybody, I love you all so much. Thank you all for coming out to celebrate someone who was so special. So special. And we're all gonna miss him in our own way. But he still live on in our spirits, in our hearts, in our minds. So thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I just want to take this one step further. If Trevin ever did anything to help you to extend the heart of gold that he had, can we just stand up and give him a round of applause? Everybody, let's give God praise. Let's salute our friend. Let's salute this gift that we have from God. Come on, we can do better than that. If you got any memories of Trevin coming to help you when you needed him, that's the kind of guy he was. Oh, man. Thank you. Thank you. I'm just going to continue to echo everything that's been said. You know, some ceremonies that you deal with, you know, sometimes you have to contrive certain things, you know. But no one has to get up here and pretend, make anything up about Trevin. Trevin, let me backtrack. I'm Craig. We met back in high school, catching the bus home, and instant bond the first day I met Trevin. Amen. And we've been friends throughout the years, basically like brothers. And he came to my house a few weeks ago to help me install the TV. And he was so, you know, he was so happy about that. It's what I do, boy. It's what I do. See that TV? I did that. I'm like, you did that. You know what I mean? And then he did that. I'm flash free. Dog, I come to the crib, let's get some big booty ribs. Some big booty chicken, dog. I'm like, big booty ribs? I don't know. But, oh, man, sometimes you got to laugh to keep from crying. I'm not even gonna pretend. I'm not even gonna pretend that I'm not crushed right now. But I know the confidence that we have in the Lord. He is our strength, He is our present help in time of trouble. And the level of grief that we have represents the level of love that we have for that person. Yes. So it's okay to grieve, but we don't grieve like we don't have a hope. So I know that Trevin knew the Lord, and we talked about the Lord over the years, and I know he called on the name of the Lord whenever he needed to. And God gives us a promise, like you said, to be absent from the bodies, to be present with the Lord. Well, we all aspire to be at some point. So yes. We're going to carry on the memories. We're going to carry on, cherish T-Rock.
The Rock.
Oh, my God. So many memories, but we trust the Lord to give us the peace that passes understanding. Yes. So I just salute the little family, his Pam, Keith, his sisters, all of his children, everyone, his aunts, everybody. We salute you. We're with you. Praying
for you,
ready together, and we shall meet again. God bless.
Amen. All right, quick. There's a gray Altima blocking someone in out in the driveway to leave. A gray Altima.
Let everything that have breath
praise the Lord.
Let everything that have breath
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. God bless you all. I'll tell you, Pam, I have not seen you in quite a while. Trevin's godmother, just my baby. I loved him. I love that boy. I tell you, I call them all boys because, you know, they're young. I just call them boys and babies. But I look in my car and I see his hand. I mean, everything, he fixed it. The alternator. I mean, battery. Come on, let's go down at Vance Auto and just call me when you get there. Just sweet. We were in touch about 5 hours before this happened. 5-6 hours, not even 6 hours. The texts and so forth, I look on the phone. You know, when he go out of town, he went out of town earlier this year, and I said, call me when you get there. You hear me, boy? He said, yes, ma'am. Yes, mama. Yes, and he called, mama, we made it safe. I said, oh, thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. But when I say a heart of gold, you know, like the young man said that was up here, you can't make stuff like that up. He touched hearts and people's lives. I mean, I would call sometimes and I'm like, Trevin, I'm so sorry to bother. He said, mama, what's up? I said, last thing I told him earlier this week, as a matter of last week, I said, Trevin, why don't you just adopt me and file me on your taxes and get it over with? Boy, he would laugh. And I remember, I was just reading all the texts, you know, that we were texting back and forth throughout the past year. And I was just looking at, he said, mama, how's the car? How's the car treating you? I said, better than my last two husbands. Boy, and he laughed. He laughed. He thought it was the funniest. I said, oh yeah, it's doing me pretty good. And he was just about to fix my brake lights. I texted him, I said, Trevin, I said, the brake lights are staying on. And he's like, oh, they're staying on. He said, I know exactly what it is. And he was saying about a little box, yeah, and he would educate you. I felt like a mechanic because he would really educate me and tell me what, he said, now mama go, and he went, I went to the store and he says, it's a tool, you're gonna have to take off the positive pulse on the battery because it will kill your battery when you go home and the brake lights are still on, it's gonna drain your battery. And we had just gotten this battery, so I didn't want my battery dead. And he said, make sure, and I said, Trevin, I hate to bother you again. He said, mama, what's up? It was just so cute. We had that friendship, you know, / mama. And I tell you, when they said early, he loved his mother. I tell you, Pam, he loved you. He loved his brother. He loved his children. TJ, I called TJ PJ for years. And he said, mama, his name is not PJ, it's TJ. I said, oh. But we must continue to keep him alive in our hearts and in our minds. Pam, I'm Kendra's mother, and you're probably, if you look at me, you can see the face right there. She is, I'm speaking enough for both her and me. She is just so broken. Our hearts are just, I tell you, it just, I thought I was dreaming. I really did. I thought I had to go and lay down. I'm gonna be honest with you. I had to lay down. And I said, when I go to sleep and wake up, I'm gonna have a text on my phone from him.
That's what I
said. I said, I know we get it. This is not real. It's just really not real. But God is faithful. And I've heard many say that he knew the Lord. He was drawing so close to God. I mean, he started even putting praying hands on the text. It was so cute. But he was serious. He was serious. He wanted to do what was right. He really did. And I thank the Lord. I thank him. Pam, you all, thank you for sharing Trevin with us. Thank you. Thank you for sharing him with us. And I thank the Lord and all of us here. Please, if you don't know the Lord Jesus in the pardoning of your sins, get it right. Get it right. We don't have this. I think this is the same church that my other godson, we had his service just, what, 2.5 years ago, 3 years ago. We got to get it right. Get it right. Get it right. Be ready to meet him. Amen. God bless you all.
Forcing me to talk, y'all, but it's all right. It's all right, because I ain't shy. My name is Patricia. I'm Shay's cousin, TJ's godmother, all that good old stuff. Anyway, I lost my brother 2 years ago, and thinking that nobody really cared, actually, Trevin called me. He said, hey, I ain't gonna ask you if you're all right, because your brother just died. But, you know, he was a loud mouth, right? And if he owe me $10, does that mean you gotta pay me? if he owe you $10, you stuck. It's like a business. So yeah, Trevin was my friend too. You know what I mean? Like, I've been knowing Trevin for 13 years, since TJ was born, you know? So, but yeah, he will be missed. He was loved. Ms. Gwen, thank you for letting us love him the way we could, you know? And everybody else that knew Trevin, I'm sure y'all said it, you know, he was loved. But yeah, them $10, Trevin, you get that from a brother, because they'll feel good now. You know. Much love. All right.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. I believe y'all can do better than that. I said give the Lord a hand clap of praise because he's worthy to be praised.
Yeah.
I'm going to give y'all another chance. I took my grandson to a Miami Heat game, and all Dwayne Wade did was hit a three-point shot. And everybody in the stands stood up. This is a good Friday, y'all.
Yes,
y'all ought to stand up for Jesus today.
Yeah.
This is a good Friday.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is a good Friday,
yes,
y'all.
Yes.
Come on, how many of y'all can do better? Come on with that low clap. Come on, give God some big clap, hand clap, praise because of the goodness of God. Amen. You may have your seats. I wasn't going to say anything until tomorrow. And I was talking with the pastor. I said, you know, tomorrow ain't really promised to none of us. So I'm going to do it while the blood is still running warm
in your veins.
In my veins.
Trevin
was my nephew, and I found out something that I was his favorite uncle. And I told him one day, I said, you know, we used to talk, I used to pick him up for work, and we used to talk, and I said, man, rest yourself easy. Your father is gone to be with the Lord, which is my brother. And I said to him, I said, I just believe, Trevor, that if the Lord called me home before him, that my brother would take care of my children, give them encouragement, talk by and see about them. So it kind of marinated with him the next morning. He said, you know what, I know now I got two dads. I said, yeah, you got two dads, I'm your dad. So we worked that day and I asked him to do something and I came back and he didn't do it. So he started talking like noise to me. And so I talked noise back to him. He said, I didn't know you talk like that. I said, I didn't know you were going to act like that either. But he was a wonderful person. And I just believe today that, amen, looking at his mother and the rest of their family, God had planted something that would never die in their life. And I believe today, amen, Pam, God got you covered. And Trevin showed me something, and I still take medication. And every morning he would say, what are we going to eat? I said, man, we get some. Let's get to the job. I said, I got to have something before we get to the job. But I understood something, that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. And he showed me that we would stop and we would go sometimes to Sunday's. I would call it here and get what we're going to eat, and we would get biscuits with our meal. And we would always save our biscuits for TJ and Isaiah. So one particular day, the last day that he worked with me before the Lord called him, he got the biscuit, his two biscuits, and I looked on the dashboard and I pulled off and got to the corner and said, oh no, let me go back, because TJ ain't gonna wanna share his biscuits. So I'm gonna make sure Isaiah have his two biscuits. And so one day I called TJ to the truck and I gave him $10. And I said, Trevin, is Isaiah in there? He said, yeah. I called TJ back. I said, take one of those $5 and give it to Isaiah. He looked at me like, I don't want to do that, right? So I said to myself, what I'm going to do, I'm going to give him $10 and give $10 to Isaiah. Because you're supposed to do the same thing for one that you do for the other. Somebody ought to say amen. Yeah, you ought to do that. And knowing that Trevin, that Sunday, I came from church and I walked up to my door and I got a hedge there. And sometimes it blooms and sometimes it doesn't. But this particular day, when I looked at the hedge when I was coming to the door and I backed up, I said, duh, I ain't never seen it bloom all over. Wow. And that night, I was in the bed and he texted me. He said, I'm working in the morning. I'm on the train in the morning. I texted him back, okay. So 7 o'clock that morning, my Aisha called me and said, Trevin gone. I said, gone where? He said, he had a heart attack and accident, right? So I said to myself, I said, Lord, thank you for the way you do things. Trevin had put his kids to sleep.
He always had money, you see. He knew what he was going to get. And by the Lord's way, y'all, I say his way, God took him down that road. Had to veer off after all had shut down in his body. He didn't have no bruises on him. None of that stuff. And nobody else got hurt. So I said to myself, there's a bright side to this. Y'all don't see it, do you? See, there's a bright side to it. And knowing the bright side that's to it, that God didn't let him suffer. He took him in his arms, took him on to glory. How many of y'all believe that is sometimes you got to know who's picking you up? God picked him up, carried him on the glory. And when God got you in his hands, no man can pluck you out. And I just believe today all of the folk that are here, he did something in your life that you would always remember him for one thing or another. In the midst of living, we might see it looking like God took him too soon. A lot of us can attest that we should have been dead and gone too. But Lord, the Lord let us live on. So we got to thank God. I said we got to thank God for everything that happened in our life. Because there's nothing we've done so good or so great. But it's by the mercy of God. And lastly, I want y'all to stand up for Pam again. Stand up for his mother. She's standing strong, y'all. A lot of mothers were in her parents. And she had a relationship not only with the Lord, but she had a relationship with her son. Y'all may have a seat. I just want to share this little story, and I'm going to take my seat. There was a man that was going away on a trip and he wanted to buy a flower that would never die. So he went down to the nursery owner and he said, I want to buy a plant that would never die. So the man sold him the plant, he went home, planted the plant in his backyard, and he went on about his journey. But when he got back, a storm had arose. So he went back looking for the flower that he planted, that the man sold him, told him that it would never die. And the plant wasn't there. So he went back to the nursery owner and he said, I thought you sold me a plant that would never die. He said, take me to your house, the nursery owner. He said, take me to your house, show me where you planted the plant. So he took him to the house and they went in the backyard and he said, I planted it right here. So the man asked him, he said, did you look on the other side of the house? He said, no, I didn't go on the other side. He said, let's go on the other side. And when they got on the other side of the house, the plant had caught root on the other side. Trevin just left this side to catch root over on the other side. Come on, give God praise. Amen. Because all of us are precious in the sight of God. Because everything that he made in creation, he said it was good and very good. That tells me that God didn't make no junk. Everything that he made, it was good and very good. We're going to close out now because I know his mother and family, they need to get some rest, y'all. And so I want you all to stand now, if you will, stand please. Service will be tomorrow at 11 o'clock. Amen. And the repast will be over at New Macedonian Baptist Church, 2201 40th Avenue West Park. Amen. Hold somebody's hand. Hold somebody's hand. You want to say something? Come on. His brother wants to say something before we close out. Thank you.
never met nobody that loved me more than my mother. And church was always beautiful, attended at all times. Because in church, you got to calm down sometimes. Everything don't have to be that loud. I saw you when you came in, that boy would be yelling so loud. Not upset about anything, but just because he just talked loud. He said, come here. My brother was so proud of me. That boy loved me. Tell me, I remember one time I had gotten, I was telling somebody else's story, I had gotten his car, his Acura. It was silver. And Trevor saw that car. He would have thought that I had bought the car from Trevor. He was so hyped about me. My new car, he was so happy that I had that car. Then I had to think about it. I said, I don't know why you're so happy because you're not going to drive it. He's talking about, you got to get, I got to watch him, so I'm going to drive it to the gas station. I said, well, I guess you have the point. My brother loved me. So if I could just offer this to all of you, I believe it. Take care of ourselves and take care of one another. Because everything ain't all that serious all the time. You understand? And I always tell people, for most of us, you know, we got more years behind us than we got ahead of us. Calm down
Amen. Grab somebody's hand. Everybody get somebody's hand. Amen. Close out. Let's bow our heads. Most eternal Father, we thank you now for Reverend Wallace. Thank you, God, for the War Chapel family. Pray your continuance to be upon them, guide them along the way. But most of all, now, God, I ask that you would wrap your loving arms around this family. The many friends that come from near from afar.
Yeah.
But we know, God, that you are just God.
Yeah.
Ain't too wise to make a mistake.
Yeah.
Praying now that you would just help us, Lord.
Yeah.
To understand the things we cannot change.
Yeah.
What is your will be done in all of our lives.
Yeah.
Let us know without a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah.
That you are our God.
Yeah.
Besides you, there's none other. Praying now, oh God, as we leave this place and never your presence, that you go with us, stand by us, and now to you that is able, to keep us from falling, to present us faultless before your throne of grace, to the only wise God, our Savior, be the many power, both now and forevermore. And let us all say amen. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor,
neighbor,
I love you,
and
ain't nothing you can do about it.
Thank you.
Thank you.